It is Wednesday, although Shut Up is here. You'll see him in a minute. So it is Wednesday.
Y'all summoned me yesterday when y'all mentioned my name like four times.
Shut up.
52 degrees out there right now. Yesterday was absolutely beautiful. Do you want to say a special thank you to Grayson's crew for fixing all my flowers? Thank you. They look great. So today we'll enjoy some beautiful weather, but tomorrow we will see some rain. JC?
What are you doing? Already doing a weather forecast?
Yep.
Now, y'all may wonder, well, Jamie, why are you wearing that pink shirt today? Because Mayor Ronnie Marks said tomorrow's pink day in Athens. Well, tomorrow's sports day on Cooper & Company. We wear our school colors. I don't do anything to jinx the mighty tide. So I'm wearing it today because I'm going to be shooting video of the Pink Elephant Lunch at the Limestone Event Center coming up, sponsored by Lawler's Barbecue. They'll be over feeding everybody today. It starts at noon, but I'll tell you more about that in just a moment. Hey, thank y'all for getting up with us. I'm Jamie Cooper. This is Athens in the AM on a Wednesday morning. It's beautiful outside currently. Join me today, Seth.
Yes, sir.
Daddy-to-be. Yeah. And Donnie Shut Up Huddleston. Now, we'll be doing the Donnie's up here because we're going to talk a little LSU, too. He'll be back tomorrow. We're going to be doing mainly the debate this morning.
The debate.
And, Tom, you watched the debate, too.
I did.
And you, how do you think won?
Well, I think Romney held his own again.
Well, so we'll have to see what's going on with that. So, weather's coming up just a moment. Frank is on the phone, 230-4988. Let me run a quick break right quick, and I'll be right back with Gloria with that in just a moment. Y'all hang on this Wednesday morning, special edition, sports and politics. Y'all hang on.
Lewis & Sons has been in business for 59 years, providing quality work and services for homeowners all over North Alabama, Southern Tennessee.
Lewis & Son Roofing and Construction is now installing premium quality windows and siding. We install Simonton windows.
They were the number one rated window by J.D. Power & Associates. Not only is it a better product, Simonton is a better company. We pride ourselves in taking care of our customers. It's a relationship for us. We're from here, and we're going to be here.
Lewis & Son Roofing and Construction.
Looking for a good scare this October? Deadwood Hollow Haunted Corn Maze and Haunted Trail. Deadwood Hollow is located in Green Hill, Alabama, just north of Killen. Go to deadwoodhollow.com for directions and information. Find us on Facebook.
I'm Abby. I'm the first person you see when you come to Coleman Dental Group. Let me show you around. This is our business office. Irene, Pam, and Jana. And this is Dr. Marshall doing an exam. And this is Dr. Corman Britton. And this is LaDonna doing a cleaning. And this is Dr. Marshall working with Brittany. And another cleaning by Cindy.
Hey, I'm Dr. Alan Coleman. Visit with us here at Coleman Dental Group. You already know us.
Let's quickly go over that weather forecast. Like I said, 52 degrees outside today. Hopefully it'll be as beautiful as it was yesterday with some sunshine, partly cloudy skies. Anyway, high temperatures around 77. Enjoy that sunshine today. Tomorrow we do have 60% chance of rain where it was only 20. It has jumped up to 60%. But most of you will be asleep when the rain gets here. Probably get here about midnight and then it'll be gone by the time you leave.
I saw people tearing up, you know, animals and everything.
That's what I was doing on my knees praying, going, man, this is it. The end's coming.
Yeah. I guess I'm not doing the weather since everybody needs to run the
mouth. Well, I'll be better last Friday.
Well, I didn't.
Hey, Humps will beat it. Get off the set, man.
Yeah, last Friday was
bad.
Seth, congratulations to you and Holly. And Grandpa is going to be another little Seth running around.
Yes, sir.
Holy moly.
That is going to be another child
on
the way
to
the Williams family.
Working out.
That's what did it.
Yeah, he was working out.
Yeah, he was working out, yeah.
Wait a minute, I've been at the gym all this time. What's
he
going on here?
The results.
Work out like that, I can stand a little bit up. You know, that, lifting them weights, I don't like.
Yeah, a lot of calories.
Donnie's going to talk to them all about the debate last night. I didn't watch any of it. Watched some of it this morning. They really ain't talking a whole lot about it. Was it boring?
It wasn't like the last one. A lot of interruptions. The moderator was just all involved in everything. She should have kept her butt out. But I think that you did. I was hoping they'd just put a cage around them, let them cage fight, and whoever comes out is the victor.
They were close.
I tell you, it looked like Al Gore three times over, except Romney didn't go.
Yeah. You agree with all that, Tom? Yeah. We're going to talk more about that later.
I don't think they like each other.
No, I think they like each other. I just think that Obama's trying to beg for his job. Obama's really begging. I mean, if you look at
he has to at this point.
All right. Well, go ahead. I know some people now get a few complaints every now and then. People say, don't be talking politics. It's my show, okay? Keep watching. We'll try to calm down a little bit on that. But let me tell you how you can get in touch with me on my iPad. CountryRover@gmail.com. That's all you got to do. Country Rover, and I've got my own iPad. I can return a message now, so I know how to do all
but
that.
Will
stuff.
You?
I'm catching
you
up,
Donnie.
You haven't returned any of my messages.
Well, I just now found out how to do it. Don't forget, we'll talk with Seth just a little bit too. 10% off every Wednesday at Herbs and More right down the highway here across from Clem Tire. I've done that well yesterday. Give a shout out to them, getting my key fixed where I can open the Hummer now that I turned the key in.
And you've got a good deal. If you're pregnant, you get 15%.
Yeah. Hey, trick-or-treating comes up 2 weeks from today. What is the best candy? They got a thing going on. Snickers is, but the number one candy last year would be what, Tom? Max, you're trick-or-treating?
No.
Reese's Pieces.
I was going to say Reese's.
Seth?
Yeah, I like that.
Doesn't David go trick-or-treating?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Reese's Pieces.
We just don't eat it.
And Alabama, according to the Huntsville Times this morning, I got to give a shout-out to the Huntsville Times. In my mailbox this morning, by 4 o'clock, they finally get in the hang of it again. Best places not to trick-or-treat, Alabama. San Francisco's the number one place. Why? Everybody sweet out that way?
Yeah.
San Francisco, number one place to trick-or-treat.
You got to figure out what your costume is because you're going to
get mugged.
Well, you can go naked out there, can't you? Johnny B said you can go naked as long as you carry a towel with you.
Something I don't want to see.
Oh, you put it over your face? Hey, trick-or-treat.
Some people need to wear clothes.
Yeah. Yes, they do.
Yeah, I've been to being probably the only one that's been to a nudist camp. Yeah, a lot of people need to wear clothes. But anyway, not even a southern state's listed on here of top 20 places to go have. That's in the Huntsville Times this morning.
Sounds like top place to get mugged.
The real reason I wanted to talk about this morning, the big article in the Huntsville Times this morning on the front page.
Is?
How much TV you watch, Tom? By average day.
Oh, gosh. Well, I have it on it. The news on it, the office.
On that, Tom's got the oldest television I've ever seen of anybody. He's got one of them that weighs like 300 pounds, but it
doesn't
color.
It's big.
Yeah.
Well, it was one of the first remotes that came out.
Is a remote to that?
Yes.
Does it work?
Yes, I use it.
Yeah, because you know he ain't getting up out of that chair to get up
and switch
channels.
You don't watch much TV?
Not much at all.
All right, I probably watch 5 hours a day TV.
Oh, my gosh, you watch that much?
I get about 30 minutes, maybe.
I watch about 5 hours a day. This is a story about Alabama's love affair with a box. It comes in different sizes and styles. Alabamians consistently watch primetime TV. I don't, especially reality shows. However, when it comes to ESPN, Birmingham is the third greatest market for the National Spelling Bee, and more than twice as likely as the country to watch it. Only Kansas City and Memphis drew a higher percentage of people who watch 14-year-olds learn how to spell. But however, when it comes to ESPN, Birmingham is one of the number one markets. It's number one for ESPN News, ESPNU, and ESPN Classics. It's a stranglehold on Birmingham that can't attribute only to college football, and they watch a little other sports too. It says here, the ratings there are just 57% basically watch sports out of Birmingham. That's extremely high.
Well, and that's because they don't have anything else. But
yeah.
I mean,
that's,
you know, live in Birmingham, yeah, but the streetlights about to go out because they're bankrupt.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, what else you got to do?
There may be a correlation.
You're unemployed
here
at this time of your life because there's no jobs out there, so you got to watch TV while you have to.
10 straight years out. And by the way, college basketball is high there, too, and NBA basketball watching is high in Birmingham also.
Because you have no professional
sports.
You ain't
got no job.
Yeah, no job.
Birmingham had the nation's highest rating for all day programming on ESPN. 84% above the national average. Above, 84% above. So that means, I guess I got nothing to do down there.
Yeah, well, if I didn't have no job, I'd sit there and watch TV all day.
Exactly right.
And another thing, it's a coincidence.
Democrats running it.
It's where I'm coming to you, Sam. There's a coincidence in TV. We're fat. Is it a coincidence?
Well, no.
Well, you're sitting on a couch.
Alabama's relationship with television may provide entertainment, but is it a love affair really healthy? We're the sixth fattest state in the nation. Well, 32% of adults considered obese. If a person is not watching TV, it's possible not a given that he or she would be doing something active that could lose weight.
Well, I know this is astonishing, but you can actually walk in place while you watch TV. You can do setups while you watch TV. I swear, it's nothing for me to get down on the floor and do setups while I'm watching TV. You don't have to sit there and eat.
Let me stop you right there. If I'm watching television, the last thing on my mind is getting in the floor doing the freaking sit-up.
Well, now,
I mean, come on.
Listen, when's the last time you did a sit-up?
Okay.
Well, yeah, good point.
Let's just be honest.
Everybody ain't you.
Most things on TV aren't worth watching anyway. I walk into the house, and I see one of these reality shows.
Yeah, I
watch it for 5 minutes, and
Doug
I feel
Dynasty.
Dumber. You might as well do
honey
something.
Honey Boo Boo, Doug Dynasty. I mean, Abby loves Doug Dynasty. She wants to marry that old man over there. He's got to be 90 years old.
Well, at least there's somebody on the list.
I don't know what it is.
I watch ESPN mainly. I watch a lot of Fox News, ESPN, and then I love to watch the Country Rovers. How many times y'all think I've seen them? And I love to watch the replay of Cooper and Company. I watch 5-6 hours a day of television. That's just what
well,
I do.
Well, you should.
Must be nice.
You own a TV station.
But I love television.
It's your job. If it was my job, I'd watch it all the time, too.
We're going to get back on this in just a moment. We're going to get off on sports right quick. LSU's going to have to forfeit all the games they've won this year, possibility, according to NCAA,
you know
because the Honey Badger.
It's funny how this comes out right before we play Alabama. Come on. That'll sound like
we'll
a Tennessee kind of thing
later,
going on here.
Let's talk about some important stuff right now.
No, it's not a joke.
No, it's true.
It just
came out yesterday.
I mean, all they can do is look at a – I could take a picture.
Clarksville, Tennessee. Police have found a Clarksville family missing pet monkey nearly 110 miles away in Petersburg.
Is it Dooley? He's the missing monkey?
According to reports, the $3,000 Marisette monkey named Gizzy was shaved. Its fur had been shaved to alter its appearance. It had not had anything to eat. Traveled to Petersburg, which is right up the road. The monkey likely would have not been recovered if not for media recovering the theft. Gizzy's owner said they came home September 28th to find the front door prized open and the door to the monkey's cage was open and remnants of French fries that he had eaten the night before were left there.
So,
I'm not making this up.
Somebody shaved the monkey?
They shaved the monkey to alter his appearance.
I ain't shaving the monkey.
I wouldn't a heartbeat. They shaved the monkey.
I knew this was going to go down here.
Oh, this is ugly.
But they shaved the monkey and found it 110 miles away. So if you got a pet monkey, I guess feed it French fries. But keep him in a cage where nobody can get in and steal him. My cousin once had a pet monkey.
Did they shave the monkey?
No. They shot him out of the tree. He wouldn't come down. My uncle was drunk, took a gun, shot him right out of the tree.
That's bad.
All right, here's another story for y'all this morning.
Please.
Florida. Authorities say the winner of a roach-eating contest in South Florida died shortly after downing dozens of the live bugs as well as worms, Tom. Mm-hmm. The grand prize in Friday night, here's what the grand prize was, a live python.
That's pretty good. Well, see, that just shows us a moral.
Where did you get these stories?
The Broward County Sheriff's Office said in the news release it's waiting for an autopsy to give the official, I can't tell you what the official called death with, stupidity. The news release Monday said Edward Archibald, 32, became ill after weaning and collapsing in front of the reptile store where the contest was held. The store, 40 miles north of Miami, was taken to the hospital where he was pronounced dead. Several contestants ate the insects, but no one else became ill.
Okay, if you find...
Now they ain't fattening, are they?
No, actually it's full of protein, but if you find yourself in a roach-eating contest, you really need to evaluate your what you have going on in your life. You need to find a job.
Roaches are good for you.
That's nasty.
Actually, yeah, they would be full of protein. All insects are nothing but muscle, and it's full of protein.
Gross.
It would be good for you.
I wonder how a roach would compare to an oyster. Now,
Wait a minute. I like oysters. I ate those this weekend down in New Orleans.
They call shrimp the crickets of the sea. So.
Yeah? Well, there you go. All right. I just want to...
Now that we've disgusted you this morning.
Appreciate you eating breakfast. And roaches and worms. And
there you go.
I got plenty of stuff to talk about when I start doing the news here in just a second.
I hope it's better than what you've been talking about.
Dear Abby, it's just kind of got my panties in a wad this morning.
Oh, great.
When I wear them. You know, that one size fits all is true.
Yeah.
It says one size fits all, so I tried them on.
Yeah.
A little tight, but. Dear Abby, I'm engaged now, this out of today. From the beginning, I knew my fiance and I would have to pay her own wedding. Well, during a recent discussion with my dad, who's divorced my mother, and everybody usually is, he offered to chip in a reasonable amount and asked me to see if my mother would match it. Well, she agreed. My mother thought it was a great idea and agreed. A week or so later, she wrote me a check for the amount that my dad had, so I deposited them both into my saving account. I had a high-paying job and a roundabout wedding date. I have since left my job, and now the wedding has been postponed. Mm-hmm. My mother has now requested I return the money because she's behind on her bills. Frankly, Tom, I think it's inappropriate for her to ask me to return her money when it was supposed to be a gift. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you something, you ungrateful little witch.
How do you really feel?
Well, it goes on to say, when your mother gave you the money to your wedding, both of your financial situations were different than they are today. This isn't a question of etiquette because you won't be needing it. I say, give me my friggin' money back.
He should want to help his mom.
You don't ask for your money back anyway. You say, listen, you didn't hold up your end of the bargain.
You said you was going to do.
Give my money back.
Okay.
Oh, so the wedding's off.
The wedding's off. Here's another thing. This is kind of in your category. I'm just, you know.
Here.
Some kids are ungrateful for what they have. Yeah, you see somebody standing behind you? My daughter and her husband have a wonderful little boy, Matthew, who's three. They say they don't plan on having, it's coming from the grandmother, they don't plan on having any other children, Jamie. I'm upset they won't be giving my grandson a sibling. They claim the reason is to be earth-friendly. I think it's being selfish. My daughter has a brother who's close to her. Her husband has two siblings. I think the main reason they don't need more children is my son-in-law is 17 years older than my daughter. Is there any good way to tell her how upset this makes me? It ain't none of your freaking business, Grandma.
Yeah, exactly.
And if they don't want more children,
this whole earth-friendly thing, if you believe that humans are the problem in the earth anyway, then, you don't need to have children because you're a sick human being.
Well, what grandmother? Now, Gwen may be the same way. I don't know. She may have forced y'all to have another kid. But if you don't, get over it.
You know, it's rough.
And then I got a story coming up in USA Today about how many people today, your age, Tom, my age, whatever, either all of us could attribute to this, are letting their parents, aging parents, move back in with them. And if it's not them, it's their adult children.
Well, see, this is why we promote health, because my parents are going to have to stay healthy, and they ain't moving in with me.
Well, my parents,
I've heard it right here first on Jamie Cooper's TV.
Yeah. I ain't got room for nobody.
He's getting laid off next week, so.
All right, that's about it. We're going to talk about the debate coming up. We'll talk with Seth. Hey, y'all need to stay healthy. You had a packed house last night for your health conferences you're doing once a week down at Herbs and More. We'll talk about that in a little bit, too. And y'all don't know that. When I gave that shout out to Jason last week, giving him that massage, that was Seth without a shirt on, not me. I just want to make sure I didn't know that. Yeah. Dieter's lot. I've lost 4 pounds in 2 days because I told you I wasn't going to become chubby.
Good job.
Not more than I already am. Right now, we'll take a break. Be right back. Y'all, hang on.